Hi, good evening. Lane Green's my name, from 1678 Water Lane, Palatine. Thanks for the opportunity to talk to the Finance Committee. Really just two points. I know we're getting into discussions about post-budget, the tentative budget was approved and I presume was submitted by September 30 through to the state. But just following on from last month's meeting, if you recall, I did present a chart with some financial numbers on it to the full board. And I did end off my presentation with an offer to talk to anyone on the board or the administration about the numbers and whether my numbers were accurate, relevant, etc., etc. I only had one contact from a member of the board, so I'm curious just to understand whether the other six members of the board or the administration, what the perspective is on the numbers, because I did try and present a case, I think, for presenting that there was a significant surplus of funds available already, which to my mind and to the mind of a number of others who presented at that meeting or whose letters were read out, indicated that there was no financial need to raise taxes. And I'm talking there about the tax levy adjustment as well. Okay. So I do want to maintain that offer open to discuss with anybody at any time that we can find a time to talk to. The second point is that, and I can be corrected on this if I missed it earlier on in the year, but it seems to me that the administration presented the Board of Education with a tentative budget, one scenario. In other words, here is a tentative budget, we'd like to discuss it with you, we'd like to approve it. My experience in 40 years worth of financial management with a variety of organizations, education, for-profit, non-for-profit, indicates to me that what normally happens in the budget process is that some scenarios are developed so that the board is presented with a variety to consider. When you have a choice of one, really the answer is approve or not approve. When you have two or more scenarios, you have a chance to weigh up the parameters and the assumptions that go into those two scenarios, especially if those two scenarios could be somewhat different in their projection. And the same would go on with three. And I realize we don't want 10 scenarios, but I think good governance would indicate that some options should be considered so that the board could have an informed discussion and look at and say, this scenario appears to be better in line with our approach than that scenario, and move towards adopting that kind of budget. And I'm curious as to why that practice is not in place along those lines. So our hope as we go down this particular exercise now, going towards looking at the next important financial decision for this board, as I understand, is the approval of the tax levy, I do hope we're going to look at some scenarios. Thanks.